Hello everybody and welcome back to Farming Simulator 17. Right, first of all today we're going to go for a different job. It's going to be a little bit of forestry, but not probably the type of forestry you're thinking of. It is still cutting down trees, however, it isn't with big equipment. To some people that's probably disappointing, but to others just seeing the forestry in the first place is going to be quite a nice thing to see. So let's just head up here. This is our tool of today, this and a chainsaw. We're going to load the logs into the back by hand. We're going to lift them up, making sure they're small enough so we can actually handle them. And then just pretty much take them over to a sell point, to the place for the wood. And we'll be able to get a bit of money from them, hopefully. Now, apparently up here, I didn't want to do this, but I just can't help it. When I'm reading the comments, I accidentally read people's suggestions and stuff, where they say, there is a gold nugget up here. There we go. We now have four. So just six left until we get a reveal of all of them. Anything in here? Oh, it's quite hard to walk around in here. No, nothing in here. So we'll move on to today's job. And yeah, it's a good job we already own the chainsaw. I know we already own it because I always equip it by accident. It's just here. It's a shortcut on my mouse. So this is the size of tree we're looking for today. The big ones, obviously, we can't handle too easily by hand. If they're small enough, we could do. But yeah, as long as it goes left, then I'm happy. It'll probably go right after all this. Okay. Magic tree. Oh. Well, the good thing is, because we're handling it by hand, we'll be able to still pick them up very easily, despite it rolling down here. So, about this size, I'd have thought. About that. If they do start to roll away, we'll have to move them as we go. Yep. Where do you think you're going? I don't know if we need to open the tailgate or if we can just do it anyway. Just dropping it in. Let's just see. Oh, whoa. Much smaller than I thought. Even this one should fit. Oh, don't throw it. Yeah, actually, we could do a bigger tree. That one only just doesn't fit. We'll trim it down. There we go. Such a nice feature to have, being able to handle stuff by hand. You wouldn't have thought it was a big ask, but it's amazing what a difference it makes to the game, having it. This one should do. I would say this is our limit though. We don't want to go any bigger. But again, if you go too small, then it just makes it boring to pick up. Whoa, timber! Run down the length of it. Taking all the foliage off. Works very effectively. And log it up. Here. Thing is, if they're too big, we won't be able to move it by hand and then we'll be stuck. Although I can just trim them down, I suppose. We'll move the pickup closer because in real life these would still be very heavy. Okay, how many more? Just one. Can we pick that up? Oh, we can. Amazingly. I should think carrying this up this steep bank here in real life would really wear you out. You'd have to be pretty strong. Although it's only pine, it's still heavy. This is not going to do the truck suspension much good either. What's so amazing is the truck actually does respond to it. The suspension does respond. Okay, so we'll put it here, and we'll pick the next one up, load it in. Probably better if I actually go right up to it like this, just helps. And yeah, I don't know how much we're going to get in, especially with my terrible stacking. We could stack really well. Just pull this one over if we can do, It's quite heavy. I would have thought this would be the only tree, well, the last tree we can get in, but we'll have to see. Thing is, if you get too much in, when you go around a corner, they're going to come flying out. That might have to be trimmed. Let's just see. Maybe not. Little one here. Little but long. Get that in the back. Oh, straight through the back window. Yeah, it disposes of the end of it. And finally, this one here. And I would say that would do it. It's, yeah, asking for trouble, really, having the glass window at the back. Whoa! Especially when you're hurling them about. Okay. Just have a bit of a brake test. Yep, they're staying in there, not going through the window. So, what we have to do now is find the sell point for this. Not sold stuff before, but I would guess it would be just here. The Stanton Sawmill, I would have thought. Is that a place you can go on the train? Maybe. But I would say it isn't, but I can't say for sure. This is the problem when I haven't really explored the train track too much. However, it's not too far from here. So if we head to the top, go down this road, and go down to here, we should just get to the place anyway. But if it turns out we do need to use a train, fair enough. We'll take it to the train and sell it that way. Whoa! I just lost a log. Sorry. They should be strapped in. I don't think you can strap them. I need to be more careful. A lot more careful. Put that in there. There, that's better. Okay, so we'll kill our speed a bit. Go steady. This should be a good speed. And as we're going this way, we'll check up on the pigs. They should be doing okay. They've got everything they need to have. They're always eating. A little bit of dirt there around the feed area. But nothing too considerable. Okay, so we have 10 pigs, 2 sheep. And everything except for the potatoes and sugar beet not being there is okay. So that should be good for a while. Alright, let's get left out of here. Mine the logs. Really don't want to lose any. And we'll head over to the sawmill. The train line is just here on the left hand side. We do need to turn left here. But still, I don't think the train line does go to the sawmill. Speed limit of 15 miles per hour. Wow, that is going to be quite hard. Speed limit 35. I should really set my speedometer to the right amount, but it is just here. I think this is the place. But no, the train, as far as I can see, doesn't go to here. But yeah, this should be the place here. You can sell wood logs here. Good. Here goes. How much money? What's it worth? Nothing too much, but it's a nice little boost. Let's do another load. I suppose we don't even have to go to the same place. We could go to a different place. In fact, we could be really cheeky and just cut down their trees here. But that would seem a bit harsh. Ah. So there is somewhere here. But is that for the really big logs? Do you load them up at the where the trains are? I know there is a crane like this there. So maybe because I've only got a small amount, that was the best thing to do. I wonder if you get the same amount of money. Okay, it doesn't do anything at all. You probably have to be in a train. But yeah, I've seen this before. I just have never shown it before in a video. But you get the general idea to unload the wood from the train. We'll have to use it in a future video when we have a massive load of wood. But for today, We're just going for the very quick and easy approach of doing it in a pickup. So back to our little forest. So, I think we could probably clear out a bit here, as long as we don't fell a tree onto the truck. And I think probably, yeah, we'll try and get more logs on this time, because before it was a bit... It looked full, but I think we could have got more on. We need to make the most of it, as it is quite a distance to the sell point. Cut it here. That deleted it. Cut it here. And, you know, we could actually put longer ones in by putting the back of the truck down, but I don't think they'll stay in place too well. Keeping them contained is the best idea. In case you didn't know, you probably do know, but if you don't, you can put the tailgate down. I have it programmed into my SATEC joystick, so I can control it. You can stop it halfway if you want to. It's very dynamic, so that's nice. Nice little feature. Where did we get to? It's a bit laggy here. Just move them out of the way. That's quite a long log, and for some reason it is very laggy here. So laggy, in fact, we might have to move. That, look at that, that is so close. Only just doesn't fit. If I put it down, yeah, but there we go, that'll do. Just nudge it. Yeah, why is it so laggy? Weird. Okay, if we stack them horizontally, give them more space. But this is a big tree, without a doubt. I believe the bigger the tree, the more money you get for them. Can we pick that up? We can! That must be heavy. Okay, drop it in. See the suspension go down. Next one. Got to be very careful when turning, because if you turn too quickly, it'll just throw it. And you'll have to pick it up again. Right. We can definitely fit more in here. So, nothing too big. Probably, which one should we go for? It's quite a small one here. Come on, fall. Probably get a disc of wood out of that. Yeah, it's gonna split there, look. We get a disc of wood, yeah, frisbee! Come here, frisbee. Whoa, whoa, what the? The piece of wood lifted me up. That was genuinely not a cheat. I actually took off, it's the hovering frisbee. That is weird. Must be worth a fortune. Where's my tree? Here. Oh, come on. There we go. About this length. Then once again we'll get it loaded up. I think this time we'll probably be overloaded before we could have fit more in. But it'll be fun to see it. The suspension is going to be like a pancake. It's going to be sat on the road. Anything else here? What is all this? Foliage. That might do us. Because if we cut this here, we'll lose the end. There. Okay. It should be lights for the top. But oh well. be interesting to see nonetheless. Now eventually, when we have a lot of money spare, we'll get a stump grinder, probably on a JCB skid steer loader, and then we'll be able to get rid of these, but it's not essential. Oh! Superman is here. We can tip over the pickup. At least the lag's gone, that's much better. Okay, if we stack them really well, they shouldn't fall out, but there's always a risk, especially with the manic driving. And this can be the final load of today. We don't want to do too much. Too much excitement in one day is not good. And that should do it. Thought it was going to roll out. Just push it over a bit. Perfect. And that actually doesn't look too bad. We should probably take a screenshot of it. We'll move out into the open. Okay. It'd be good if there was strapping. I don't think you can strap in the pickup. Obviously in real life you'd definitely ratchet strap this in. But no, you can't do. That is a shame. I mean, it wants to move so easily. Maybe if we put that down a little bit. Yeah, I'll do a screenshot. There we go. Screenshot done. And now to set the speed limit to probably about 35. I would have thought, otherwise everything is going to be everywhere. Even at 35, oh, that could be a bit much. It is indeed. Okay, it's holding on just about. Stay on the right hand side of the road. And it's gone. Sorry for all of you realism fans. I suppose it's not necessarily my fault because I would like to strap them, but I could drive better, a lot better. So we'll stick it at 35, that seems to be okay, just on the corners they do fly out. And let's see how much money we get for these. It should be quite impressive, like 60 or 70 pounds per log. It's quite a bit in there, but we just need to be very careful. 35 still feels quite fast. Almost fell out. But still, it is all extra money. It's quite hard money, but at least it's extra. So I think it's all intact, it's all there. Let's go into the box and see how much it's worth. £1 for that. The hovering disc was a pound and it hovered? Something is not right here. I've been ripped off. There was something magical about that. That is crazy. Okay, calm down. Let's move on to the next job. The next job is, well, we've got the silage bales, they do need work. They need to be stacked somewhere neatly. Hang on, one of those logs was worth £100. And then another one was worth 12. Bit of a price difference there. Anyway, £123, one of them. That's crazy. Well, yeah, let's just go and work on the bales. The thing about the bales is we do need to really have an auto stacker. Because you know what my stacking is like. Either that or a bale grab. But I'm really bad at using it, so I don't know. We'll take a look into it and see what to do for the best. Here we are back at the farm. All of our equipment should be here, except for the New Holland tractor. Which is over at the sell point, which we do need to retrieve. Oh, and the combine as well. So we just put this in here very quickly. Go on the store, and we need to go across to baling technology. £39,000. Everybody keeps saying, don't lease, stop leasing stuff. However, there isn't really much of an alternative here. Let me just check how much it is the bale grab. I suppose it's not totally out of the question. Or we could use this one as well. That is cheaper. So maybe. However, it is still quite expensive. Let's go for a blue. Let's go for blue. It should look quite good. Okay, so the log should have almost paid for that, I would have thought. Yes. Shut the engine off and over to the New Holland tractor. We'll bring it back. Fields in Farming Simulator 17 are just worth so much money. That's why I keep going about using the contracting to your advantage. The more you do for that farmer, the lower the price of the field. And I think that is the whole idea behind it. The only area where this does not work at all is multiplayer, because there is no contracting, so you can't push the price down. So basically, to put it kindly, every field is a rip-off. But it'll probably be changed in the future. I should have gone right there. Can we go across? No, probably not. Yeah, so we'll go back to the farm, and then we'll get the front-loaded tractor, and we'll just move those bales to a stack, probably just to the side of the field, because otherwise they'll be blocking the grass for the future. We need to cut it again in the future. Ah, oh, so close. But so far. Right, that felt like a very long way round. I should not have turned left out of there. But we are back now, finally. We'll put this tractor just somewhere in the yard, it doesn't really matter where. And where is the front loader tractor? Oh, it's over here. So we'll put that here. It could do with a wash again. So we'll do that in the future. But what we need to do is drive over to the store, wash this tractor first. It looks terrible. Really mucky. I still haven't adjusted the joystick. Should do it. Put this over here. Give it a quick rinse, and then we'll pick up the, what's it actually called? The bale handler thing. It's not a grab, it's just like tiny sort of things that go either side. It doesn't have to be immaculate, just get some of the dirt off. Yeah, that should do. There we go. Off we go. There's the poplars. Yeah, they'll be done soon. Not quite yet, because as a few of you have pointed out, it is the crop that you'd probably usually do last. It's just, I'm desperate to see the harvest. Some of you have probably already done the harvest, but we're a little bit behind here. If you use the money cheats and stuff, yeah, you'll have done it ages ago, because you'll have all the biggest equipment, but yeah, we can't afford it. We're doing this properly, nice and slow. Maybe when FS19 comes out, we'll have done the poplar harvest, who knows? I feel to be doing this trip an awful lot. We seem to be always... Sorry, pedestrian. We seem to be always at the store. Almost wiped you out, but she didn't really see, so we should be okay. So this is quite a colourful setup. We've got like... Well, we've got the case red. And then we've got my wrong colour, the maroon colour, and of course a very blue colour. Is that, that's not quite New Holland blue, is it? Not sure. But as long as this gets the bales moved out of the field, or at least to the side of the field, then we should be okay. As they are, no more crops can grow, which had a terrible thought. Because the wrapper flipped them over, are we going to pick them up? Oh dear. That is not good. This is why I was going to go with the auto stacker, but we'll see. We might be able to do it. Here we are. So there might be a bit of control adjusting required for this to work properly. As you can see, it just keeps retracting. Also, I believe it's supposed to work the other way. I can't say for sure. I'm not sure. This is where my lack of experience is not helping. However, pretty sure it shouldn't just retract like that. I put it in and then it immediately opens up again. But yeah, the bale should be the other way around. So that's not really what... Let me try over here. We have got a grass bale over here, which hasn't been flipped over. But still, the controls are off because it shouldn't open again. That's ridiculous. Oh no, I've sent it on a roll. Come here. Bail. Okay, I've messed this up. Right, I've just changed the controls. So now, as you can see, it is working. Is that how you use this tool? Is that right, or am I just totally failing here? I would love to know. I really should know. I'm pretty sure that's right. But even if I'm wrong, we can still take this off and put it somewhere. I'll put it down here. Probably this end bay, because you can't drive through. Now, I did adjust the controls. Yes, I thought that might happen. It's kind of messed up my SATEC side panel, but not terribly. I think what I'm going to have to do is just between this video and the next one, I'll try and think of a solution to all this, and we'll probably use a different tool. However, we now own this, so in the future, for doing grass bales, it's going to be fantastic. We do have this one up here, so I'll move this one too. But yeah, I'm pretty sure that is how you do it. Just like this. Just don't squeeze it too hard. Oh, it's doing that thing again. It's retracting it, I don't know why. There we go. Yeah, oh, that is so weird. Okay, well, we'll stop with the fails. That's enough failing for one video. I'm going to go away now, and we're going to work on this. And yeah, hopefully by tomorrow we'll have a bit of a solution, and it should work a lot smoother. Okay, yeah, one more thing I want to say actually. The crop destruction. There is now like a fan-made modification to it, and it stops the grass from being deleted when you drive over it. I think instead of getting rid of the mod altogether, I'll go for that, because the crop destruction is a nice feature for doing tramlines and stuff, but in the grass it's just not right. So yeah, let's just take it one step at a time. I don't want to just jump to getting rid of it, that'd be terrible. But that is it for today, hopefully you've enjoyed the video. I will return tomorrow with hopefully a better video. So until then, thanks again, and I'll see you again soon. Bye for now.